Cyberpunk is probably one of the most popular subgenres in science fiction. The cyber comes from the blurring of the line between man and machine. Punk highlights alternative lifestyles that are present in a given time period. At the core of cyberpunk, the genre itself is a thesis about human nature. Then it never changes. But I'm getting ahead of myself. First, let's contextualize all of this.
Anybody like me who grew up and was part of the Berkeley counterculture became a marked man during the Nixon administration.
In 1968, Philip K. Dick released a novel which is probably one of the most influential works in science fiction, Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? Electric Sheep came around the Vietnam War and McCarthyism era.
The imperative need for an immediate peaceful solution to an illegal and unjustifiable war.
As the book was adapted into film, Blade Runner came around 1980s. During this two-decade span, there was a lot of cultural shift. Consumerism has consumed every aspect of life. Magazines, billboards, and TV ads push for more and more and more products. It is only natural that counterculture emerged, and these punk lifestyles acted as middle fingers to the current establishment, and so did fiction.
Police once told me that I was a crusader, and they had no use for crusaders.
In Electric Sheep and later on Neuromancer, drugs became institutionalized, and most of the human experience were lived in both the physical and the virtual world. In Electric Sheep, they call these gadgets empathy boxes. They alter emotions in the same way that drugs did. Even in the beginning, cyberpunk has already been asking if the human emotion was as programmable and calculable as gadgets. Is it really the mind that's responsible? This fusion of the mind and the machine is at the core of cyberpunk. It questions not just the nature of ultra-modern societies, but the encompassing question, what does it mean to be? Glancing at these works of art, it is pretty obvious to see them as a cacophony of the 80s culture. And these are marked by huge neon signs, huge billboard ads, mixed with brutalism architecture that were popular pre-60s. Electric Sheep, which is the forefather of cyberpunk, I would argue, does not look anything like its film counterpart Blade Runner. Blade Runner was heavily inspired by 80s heavy metal comics, with dirty and imposing cityscapes. While sci-fi has already moved on from its clunky origins into sleek, minimalist interpretation of the future, cyberpunk is steadfast in embracing its retro future look. For a genre that is rooted in eternal change, it is quite frozen in time. And what I mean by this is that instead of focusing on the macro implications of futurism, the genre needs a different angle, a different focus, or in other words, personal. There is no requirement for expansive set pieces. These recent films still do deliver in the spectacle, but they also deliver on focused and personal journeys. And existential theories regarding the forward momentum of time has already been done in literature and pretty much every genre. But very few are brave enough to transcribe them into a personal journey. And like I said, this does not call for a change in aesthetic. Part of what attracted me to this genre is its striking visuals. This only calls for a change in focus. And I think this is where the beauty of it is. The stories may change, the characters may change, but at the core of cyberpunk, it's all about human nature, and human nature never changes.
I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships on fire off the shoulder of Orion.
A child of woman born.
Simple answers to simple questions.
A life of freedom.
Dia de Muertos, Thanksgiving, and of course, Halloween.
Principles of peace
All those moments will be lost in time. Like tears in rain. Time to die.